Good morning, cadets. In the previous video, we have learnt about the electromagnetic induction. That is Faraday's electromagnetic induction. When a magnet is taken in the close vicinity of a coil, if the magnet is moved, suppose the coil is connected to a galvanometer, and if the magnet is moved in and out rigorously, then the galvanometer shows the deflection. So when the magnetic field due to the bar magnet changes with respect to the turns of the coil, then a current is induced in the coil. This is an activity to show electromagnetic induction. In the same way, we have learned coil-coil experiment, and now this is also another coil-coil experiment. Look at this diagram. This is coil number 1. This is coil 2. Both are taken on a same core, and these are insulated turns of copper wire. You can say insulated copper wire is taken, and one coil is wound around the core like soft iron core, and this is connected to a battery. The free ends of this coil are connected to battery with the help of a tap key. PK means tap key, and another coil is wound on the same core, right? And this is also having insulated copper wire. There is no connection between the copper wire and the core here, and the free ends of the two free ends of this coil are connected to a galvanometer. Now the moment the key is closed, you see the current starts flowing through this number of turns in this way, and finally it flows. The moment the key is closed, you will find the deflection in the galvanometer. The deflection will be very interesting. It will be in this sense. Suddenly you will find the deflection due to the flow of current. And the moment when you close the key, during the make of the key, during the make of the circuit itself, we will find the deflection. This is what I have already explained. So what happens when we close the key? Immediately when we close the key, within just a fraction of a second, you will find the kick in the galvanometer, sudden deflection in the galvanometer. Afterwards, the pointer comes to zero. Means if you permanently close this key, constant current flows through the circuit. When the current is constant, that moment the galvanometer doesn't show any deflection. This is one thing. Second thing, when you open the key, suddenly when you open the key, break of the circuit. During the break of the circuit, what happens? Again, you will find the deflection in the galvanometer, but the deflection in the galvanometer will be in the opposite direction. It means the current changes its direction. During the break, what happens actually? The current starts decreasing from maximum current value, from some constant value which was attained earlier by closing the key. Now it is decreasing to zero value. During this decrease of current during the break of the circuit, during that fraction of second again, you will find the deflection in the galvanometer, but the deflection in the galvanometer is in the opposite direction. So this is what we call as electromagnetic induction. So we have to focus during the break of the circuit and make of the circuit. During make of the circuit, the moment we close, for that fraction of a second, we will find the deflection. During the break of the circuit, during that moment of a second, again we will find the deflection in the opposite direction. But when the key is closed permanently, when the current is flowing constantly, when there is a constant current flowing through the circuit in the coil number 1, no deflection is shown in the galvanometer. That is very interesting. What happens during the make? The current is growing from 0 to some constant value, some maximum value. During that process, what happens? The magnetic field is increasing from 0 to maximum value. The magnetic field links the second coil with the help of magnetic field lines. The magnetic field lines are linking with this coil. Those magnetic field lines result into induction of current in the second coil. So this is what we call it as electromagnetic induction, and we have defined what is electromagnetic induction, the phenomenon of inducing currents in a conductor coil, phenomenon of inducing current in the conductor coil by the change of magnetic field, by the change of magnetic field linking with the coil is called as the electromagnetic induction. So change of magnetic field takes place only during the break of the circuit or during the make of the circuit. Only the moment we close, there is a growth of current, as a result magnetic field is increasing. During the break of circuit, there is a decay of current, decrease of current from maximum value to zero value. Again magnetic field is decreasing. Due to the decrease of current, magnetic field linking with this coil starts decreasing. During that decrease of magnetic field, again field lines coming in contact with the turns of the coil number 2 are decreasing. As a result, again a current is induced in the coil in the opposite direction. So this phenomenon is called as electromagnetic induction. So this is coil experiment, coil number 1, coil number 2 experiment, and this is also called as mutual induction. This is also called as, no doubt, electromagnetic induction. In particular, it is called as mutual induction. Inducing current in one coil by the change of current and thus magnetic field in the other coil. Is called electromagnetic induction. In particular, this type of induction is called mutual induction. More about this mutual induction you are going to learn in higher classes, especially in 12th class you are going to learn in detail. Okay, this much is enough. It has got number of applications. The immediate application is going to be learned in the principle of generator, electric generator. So the electric generator is a device which generates electric current with the help of a coil rotating in a magnetic field. A coil, a rectangular conducting coil, is made to rotate in a magnetic field. When it is made to rotate in a magnetic field, current is generated in the turns of that coil, and that current is utilized for various purposes. Okay, so after learning the basic principle electromagnetic induction, we are now learning the very important application of electromagnetic induction, that is electric generator. Okay, so electric generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Electric generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. What is electric generator? Electric generator. Electric generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electric energy, that is
mechanical energy into electric energy, that is also called electricity. So it is just the reverse process of electric motor. We have already learned electric motor. Electric motor is a device which converts electric energy into mechanical energy, which is used in fans and so on. Right? We already learned. It is working on the principle of magnetic effects of electric current. Whereas electric generator is just a reverse device. It is just a reverse process. Electric generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. When a coil is rotated mechanically, with the help of mechanical energy, when a coil is rotated in a magnetic field, perpendicular to magnetic field, then current is generated in the turns of the coil. Right? That is the meaning of electric generator. It converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Okay. Before we learn electric generator in detail, construction and working of electric generator in detail, first we will learn the very important principle, very important law, that is Fleming's right hand rule. Very important rule or law, Fleming's right hand law or Fleming's right hand rule, which helps us to find out the direction of current. You have to stretch the first three fingers of the right hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Right hand, not left hand. Okay, electric motor works on the principle of Fleming's left hand rule, whereas electric generator works on the principle of Fleming's right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule, please remember. So you have to stretch first three fingers of right hand mutually perpendicular to each other, so that the finger, forefinger, it is also called as index finger. Index finger shows the direction of magnetic field. Thumb shows the direction of motion of the conductor. Motion of the conductor. And the central finger shows the direction of current in the turns of the conductor, in the turns of the coil. Right? Let us see the diagram. Now let us see the working of the electric generator with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. What Fleming's right hand rule states is that stretch your first three fingers mutually perpendicular to each other, forefinger, thumb and central finger. So when you stretch these three fingers mutually perpendicular to each other, the forefinger represents the direction of magnetic field. Thumb represents the direction of motion of the conductor. When the thumb represents the motion of the conductor, then the central finger represents the direction of induced current. Current that is induced or current that is generated in the moving conductor. Okay. So as I said, the principle of electric generator is the electromagnetic induction. When a conducting coil is moved perpendicular to magnetic field, when a conducting coil is moved in a magnetic field perpendicular to it, then a current is generated in the coil of the conductor. So this is the principle of the electric generator. Now look at the diagram. Here N and S represent the strong pole pieces of magnet. Okay, and the direction of current is always from direction of magnetic field is always from north to south, right? So this represents the direction of magnetic field lines, that is also representing magnetic field direction from N to S. And A, B, C, D is a rectangular coil. It is a single rectangular coil. You will understand better with the help of single rectangular coil. A, B, C, D, which is good conductor coil like copper, and the two ends of this ABCD conducting coil are connected to the rings. See here, AB, the end AB is connected to the ring, metallic ring R1, and the end CD is connected to the metallic ring R2 as shown here, right? And B1 and B2 are the brushes, as we have studied earlier, in the case of electric motor, B1 and B2 are conducting brushes. Conducting brushes like graphite brushes, which are very smooth, which will be in contact with the rings. B1 is in contact with R1 and B2 is in contact with R2. And both R1 and R2 metallic rings are taken over an axle. The axle is made to rotate, right? And the inner surfaces of these rings are insulated. Inner surfaces of these rings are insulated so that there is no conducting between the rings and the axle. Okay, how does it work? That is next important thing. When this coil is made to turn, suppose it is made to turn clockwise. Clockwise means, look at this. AB arm of the rectangle coil is moved up. The AB arm moves up. You see, the thumb direction is showing the direction of conductor moving up, right? And the magnetic field is shown by forefinger, index finger, L to S. And see the direction of current. The central finger shows the direction of current, right? When AB moves up like this, this central finger shows the direction of current. So this is how current flows from A to B and then B to C, then naturally C to D, and thus the current flows in this way from A to B, B to C, C to D, and then D to B2, B2 to B1, the current flows, and suddenly you find deflection in the galvanometer towards left. This is how the current flows. Because of the movement of AB arm moving up, after half rotation, what happens? Before half rotation, when the current is flowing like this, you see the current that is flowing down. Because when the arm AB moves up, obviously the arm CD moves down. Arm CD moves down like this. AB moves up, arm CD moves down. When arm CD moves down, the direction of motion is shown by thumb. See the direction of motion, thumb. And the direction of current, direction of magnetic field is shown by index finger, that is forefinger. And see the direction of current. Current is shown by this. When the CD moves down, AB moves up, CD moves down, the current is shown by central finger. That's how we find the direction of current. That's how current I is set up in the ABCDR. So after half rotation, what happens? Look at this. After half rotation, CD comes in the place of AB. AB goes in the place of CD. So now the diagram will be BCBA after half rotation. When it becomes half rotation, BCBA, BC arm is moving up now. After half rotation, DC arm moves up. When the DC arm moves up, again you see the direction of current. The direction of current is from D to C. Direction of current is from D to C again. When it moves up, D to C. When the direction of current is from D to C, then it is DCBA becomes the sense of current. DCBA. Because AB will be in this place. So in the first half rotation, the current flows in the direction of ABCD. ABCD during first half rotation. That is from B2 to B1 in the external circuit, from B2 to B1 through the galvanometer. You see, I have told you what is galvanometer.
galvanometer is a current detecting device, and also it gives you the sense of motion of current, the direction of current. If it is moving from V2 to V1, you see the deflection is towards left. Next, after half rotation, in the second half rotation, after half rotation, what happens? The current flows from DCBA. In the next half, rotation, the current flows in the sense of, in the direction of DCBA. Now it is reversed. The current is reversed. Therefore, in the external circuit, what happens? If it is moving from DCBA, now current will be flowing from V1 to V2. That is from V1 to V2. So the deflection in the galvanometer will be towards right. It will be reversed now. Now the deflection in the galvanometer is, deflection will be towards right. That's how after every half rotation there is change of direction of current. Such a current which reverses its direction after every half rotation is called as alternating current. It is called as alternating current because it is changing its direction after every half revolution. Such a current is called as alternating current. So we can define what is alternating current. The current which reverses means changes direction. Changes direction after a fixed. It is a fixed interval of time. Half rotation is called alternating current. In short, it is termed as AC. The current that we use for our home purposes, for all our domestic purposes and all, it is always alternating current. The current that we get from the main source, it is always alternating current. Alternating current has a lot of advantage over direct current. There are two types of currents, alternating current and direct current. Direct current is the one which we get from the battery, like the cells, battery or the cells. So the current does not change its direction at all if we use battery or cells. Such a current which does not change its direction, which always flows in the same direction, is called as direct current. So you can just write what is direct current.
A current.
So the current which reverses or changes its direction after a fixed interval of time or after half rotation is called alternating current. Whereas a current which does not change its direction at all is called as direct current. It is abbreviated as DC. AC, DC. So the sources of DC are like battery, cells, and even there are so many sources. DC generator also. There are DC generator also. DC generator also generates direct current. Whereas sources of AC are electric generator, AC generator. This is actually termed as AC generator. This is the structure of AC generator. So here the coil is rotated externally using mechanical energy.
it is manually rotated or externally rotated with the help of mechanical energy. For example, in a huge hydroelectric power station, what happens? The energy of falling water or energy of flowing water is used to rotate the turbine. The turbine rotates, that axle of the turbine is connected to the axle of this coil. Got it? So the coil rotates. When the turbine rotates, this coil rotates in the strong magnetic field. When the coil rotates in the strong magnetic field, it generates alternating current. So R1 and R2 are helpful in reversing the direction. And B1 and B2 are the brushes, conducting brushes, which will be in contact with these R1 and R2. Right? And here, for just detecting the current, we have used galvanometer. In place of galvanometer, if we use a bulb, then the bulb glows. And if it is in a large scale, this will be connected to the circuit, the circuitry, wherein the circuitry will be having various electrical devices like electric fan, bulbs and so on, all will be operated with the help of this generator, right? So this is just to show the detection of current. And during first half cycle, during first half cycle, what happens? The current is from V2 to V1. During the next half cycle, since the direction of current will be from DCBA, is reversing its direction, therefore what happens? The current will be flowing from V1 to V2. When the current flows from V1 to V2, you can see the deflection in the other direction. So this is the working of electric generator. DC generator is also having same structure, but the axle of this DC generator is provided with only single ring, and that single ring is split ring. That single ring is split ring, and that split ring will be connected with the brushes. Just like the electric motor, what we have studied, same structure, here it is reverse. Right? So, the difference between DC generator and AC generator is that the AC generator has two rings, R1 and R2, whereas a DC generator has only one ring, that too it is a split ring. R1 and R2 are half rings, split rings. Okay? So, that's how we study the DC generator, wherein even when the coil rotates in the strong magnetic field, in case of DC generator, when the coil rotates in the strong magnetic field, the current does not change its direction. Current will be always from V2 to V1. So such a current which never changes its direction is called as direct current. Usually what we use in our domestic purposes and our all home needs and industrial needs, we use alternating current. In our country, the frequency of alternating current is 50 Hertz. 50 Hertz. Frequency of alternating current. It means in every 100th of a second, in every 100th of a second, the current changes its direction. In every 100th of a second, the current reverses. So this is the time period. In every 100th of a second, the current reverses its direction. Reverses or changes its direction. As a result, it is called as alternating current. Okay? So if you have doubts, please ask me in the group, we'll discuss. Okay. Tomorrow we are going to learn about domestic circuits and circuitry. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.